residential proxies. I've heard another interesting term, data center proxies. I'm assuming that means that we also just use like regular servers that we rent as proxies.
Yeah.
When should we then use residential proxies as developers, and when should we use data center proxies?
Okay, so this is a very broad topic. But yeah, there are basically two types of proxies that you can have. It's data center and residential. Now, how do you know whether this proxy or this IP address is either data center or residential? There's no way of telling that right away, but there are companies around the world like MaxMind IP to location or IP info. And these companies, what they do, they basically map all the available IPs with some certain properties. So for example, there's an IP somewhere, like any single IP, and they assign that IP the owner, the location, and maybe the usage type. And since, for example, there's an IP that belongs to a company that's usually providing data center services, one of those companies, one of those IP mapping companies, they can assume that that IP address, since it belongs to a company that is providing data center services, this IP is very likely to be used in a data center. So now they show that in their database, their IP database, they show that this IP address is used as a data center IP. And now if we use this IP as a proxy, it can be recognized if it was an IP from a data center, which is which kind of means that it's used for commercial purposes. It's not probably used in residential networking and stuff like that. And on the other hand, an IP that belongs to a company that's providing residential connectivity, like AT&T, for example, Verizon, chances are that this IP address is used somewhere at home, at an office as an IP address, basically to provide connectivity to the internet. So you have these two types of IP addresses, and you can then use that information and determine what kind of IP you're seeing and then do something about it.
Yeah, so I guess what that means is that some services, say, oh, I love using potatomarketplace.com. Mm-hmm. I used it in previous episodes as an example. So let's say I am a web developer for potatomarketplace.com and I am being scraped very actively. And my idea to defend myself from web scraping would be to just look at the IP addresses that are being used and use one of those IP to location services, for example, and see if they match residential IPs or they are owned by some company.
Yeah, exactly. So this is what you could do, right? Like you said, if you're seeing a lot of traffic from an IP address, you can buy that database. You can see what kind of IP address that is. Even if it's a data center IP address, you may assume that, okay, this is something suspicious. Probably it's not a real person behind that IP address, and you can block it or you can throttle it in some way. But if it's a residential IP address, according to that database, then you might think, okay, even though this person is doing a lot of requests, making a lot of, opening a lot of pages, that IP address is residential, so I can't really block it because that probably is really a person behind it and maybe trying to buy something from my website.
So in general, I want to use residential proxies when I have a hunch that I'm being blocked, particularly from data center IPs.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons why. Why would you need to use residential proxies if you're not able to get the data from the website using data center proxies?